All right, well, I'll go ahead and get started with some welcoming comments. So good afternoon, everyone. Thank you all for joining our Business Essentials webinar today. Today we are hearing, we're going to be exploring the topic of how to thrive in businesses and how to survive and manage cash flow during a crisis such as COVID right now. We have the pleasure of hearing from James Preston with PNW Community Tax Service and Dianette. And with that, I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to you guys and just let you guys run with it. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thank you, Crystal. It's a pleasure. Well, like she said, welcome. This is How to Thrive in Business by Surviving 2020. Warm hello to all attendees. My name is Dianette Galindez. Olympia is home to myself and my family. I have been with PNW Community Tax Service since the beginning, which is 2018. We first started off as a tax firm. Now we are a full-blown business and accounting firm. Today, James Preston will be presenting. James Preston bought his first business in 1979. After four decades as a serial entrepreneur, he has acquired the PNW brand and is expanding his Profit Advisor program to clients in the PNW. He lives with his wife and family part-time in Washington. And he has also written an ebook called Five Biggest Mistakes SBEs Make, and would like to get a copy of it for free to all of you at the end. Right now, we're welcoming in James. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dianette. Also, Crystal and all the attendees. Business to me is life. And I have to be careful with how I say that because my wife reminds me love is life, family is life. And living here in beautiful Olympia, Washington part-time, I realized summer in the Pacific Northwest is also life as well. It'd actually be easier to be in here today sharing about how to collect your cash and manage it if it was storming and raining, and instead it's going to be 75 degrees today. So today I want to share briefly with you on what I have learned, what PNW offers, and most importantly, how you can take care of your business and the way that you thrive, the way that you manage cash in a recession as a financial advisor with my tax and accounting hat on is to make sure that you are changing what you're doing now. It's very important. Cash is king. The four goals of today's chat is number one, how you can get money, confirm that you're getting the SBA capital, which is the money around the 7A program, which is the EIDL. Number two, make sure if you haven't gotten your PPP money, the Paycheck Protection Act, that you are getting it. You can make multiple offerings to multiple lenders. Some of it's forgiveness if it's done right and it's been changed to be more fair to you. 60% is now available. Second, you have a lot in your control. The second goal or second leg of cash managing it during a recession has to do with the tactical tools, the things within your business. We'll take some in-depth look and I'll give you some hacks, three tips on what we share works and we see with our best clients. Third is my favorite. Strategic means you look a little bit ahead right now. Instead of thinking about your yacht or retiring in Maui, Hawaii, you're thinking about the next 30 to 90 days. Again, thriving is surviving. You'll look closely and we'll discuss how to love your clients. Make sure your marketing budget is not cut, even as you cut expenses and get in reality. And lastly, think innovatively. How can you gain market share during this challenge? And fourth, just to remind you that with your tax and accounting professionals, remember that they're the ones to help you look forward, look ahead, not just in the past with your taxes. Again, a special thanks to Dianette, and let's dive in and take a look at how we can make cash your king. But before we do that, I want to share an idea with you. For one thing, the business of America is business, by Calvin Coolidge. As I deal with my own companies, and I do own numerous ones, and talk to my team members and myself, I realize that two things jump up. Number one is you have to do planning in this kind of arena. And number two, your psychology and mindset is important. 45 million people have filed unemployment this spring. That's a staggering number for COVID. However, PNW believes every owner in person needs to see the reality that business is not business as usual. And also, it's not a negative thing. The stream coming across CNN what we see in some of our neighborhoods and my own feelings is negative. However, we as leaders, business owners, needs to see that every crisis is your opportunity. To thrive, you must survive. The first step then is to make sure you've gotten everything and time is running out around the two programs with the SBA. First of all, usually when a hurricane hits Louisiana in the Gulf of Mexico, there's an EIDL for a few counties. This time, because of COVID and our government's reaction, billions of dollars have been unleashed and the Economic Investment Disaster Loan is available. If you've already received and made application, then you're in the process. If you have not, it has been reopened. For a while it was open, then it was closed to just agriculture. Now, as of the last week, please, if you have not, and I'll show you the link in a moment, go onto the online website as a small business owner, whether you've got numerous employees or just yourself, please get in there. There's some free money available, up to $10K, $1K per person. What is the average loan amount? We're seeing a maximum amount of 25% of gross revenue. That's the 7A program, EIDL. Please get it if you haven't. Also, the loan is not something you have to take until you sign loan documents. To my knowledge, there's no prepayment penalty as well. Do it. Number two is the Paycheck Protection Program. It has over $100 billion still available. The small bankers are who you work with. We also have a list of the fintech platform lenders that are going very well, PayPal and Lendio, for example. The number there on how much you can, information and how many funds you can get is to make sure you take your 2019 number. If you're by yourself, that's your net profit divided by 12, multiplied by 2.5. If you have normal employees, you're a little bit larger, it's the same metric. Take your information for the employees. Let's take a look now at some of the more granular details of both the EIDL and the PPP. Step one is to get this money. All right, in terms of the EIDL, go to this website again if you have not yet done your application and received your funds. If it's a two-step process, you make application, you then can receive capital, $1K per employee up to a maximum of a $10K grant. That is money that's free of tax. There's nothing more you have to do with that money. And that is go to covid19relief.sba.gov/#. After you're approved, meaning you receive your number, then there will be additional loan documents in most cases. Also, there's become a cap in terms of the loan amount, the $150K. If you're a much smaller business, what we're seeing, what we're getting, and what our clients are getting, and we've done just under 100, is they're getting 25% of gross revenue. So if you're getting 100,000 as your gross revenue, subject to the cap now of 150, you're getting $25,000. The good news about this is it's a 30-year repayment program at 3.75%. And there's the other bucket of money, the PPP, as you're hearing about. The goal of this was to be involved with being able to keep your employees working in your company. It's a forgiveness program that's based now on a final interim ruling of 60% of funds can be used in payroll. Where can the other money be spent accurately over the course of the next 24 weeks? That's interest on mortgage, not principal, rent, and utilities. There are some tricks you can play in there. Realize utilities can be transportation depending on your fleet, et cetera. Also, the rehiring has been eased, and now on any non-forgiven money, it's only 1%, and your repayment is over 5 years. But please hurry. We're seeing this program expire the end of this month. We can't trust politicians all the time. They've been very generous, but it looks like this will be the end of this month. So there's really only 10 days left to make application. Please, also on the PPP, if you have not gotten a confirmation from your lender, apply to another one. This has not been prohibited, and we've seen many of our clients not have success, say through an option A, which was a bigger bank this spring. They went onto a fintech site, they got approved there. Contact us for more details. But the PPP is a great thing. All right, let's look at mindset again. I believe that we as humans can sometimes make a hell of heaven and a heaven of hell. So you'll see me through this short chat talking about cash, profits, money, one of our most and favorite topics. As small business people, you'll see me keep coming back to the psychology. See, good times come and go as well, but tough people always remain. Also, as Warren Buffett says, on a more humorous angle, when the tide goes out, you can tell who isn't wearing swim trunks. It's low tide now. One thing that's really important, though, around your mindset as a small business owner, besides being a leader, not becoming negative, but by staying positive on what you're doing, is to make sure that you're in reality. How will you thrive this year? Yes, you may still try to grow, but I urge you to succeed. Think more, not so much a scarcity mindset, but much more a realistic mindset. I suggest you begin watching your cash positions daily. One of the best ways for you, especially in a very small business, to watch your expenses is to literally write out, you can put this into your QuickBooks program if you're online, or through a ledger, jot down every expense. The very nature of watching your expenses will decrease what you spend, especially in a very small business, by up to 20%. You must be guarding your cash. Innovate or die is another one of the options. I remind you, when you started your small business, the enthusiasm, the persistence, the sort of fake smile you had day or night when people ask you how it's going, please bring that own information, get that fire unleashed, be passionate about what you have, because that's the kind of individual that in 2021 will look back and you will have grown your company. You will be more concerned about profits. See, here's the good news during a challenge during COVID and a recession is by tightening your ship, wearing your swim trunks now, when you have more profits and it's easier later, and so do your clients, then you'll be saving money. You'll be a better steward of your capital. That's sort of the offshoot. All right, step number two. Now we need discipline, not just motivation. If mindset is key, getting your cash during a recession is critical. Understand there's two or three small tactics that are very important. Number one, one of the quickest places, if you have accounts receivable, is to get in contact now with all those that owe you money. Obviously, if someone owes you a large amount and you talk to your attorney, there's legal recourse for you to recover some or all that capital. But I offer two simple areas of advice. I've been in lending for many years, and I would suggest number one, if you are wanting to bring cash into your company and you have significant accounts receivable, please give discounts for early payments. Also offer a reasonable 2, 3, or 4 months of payments. Say someone owes you $5,000, request that they pay you $1,050 for the next 5 months. That way you're getting a little bit of interest on your money received, and you're also working with, in a win-win manner, those clients that owe you money. Number two is this is the time for cash flow management. We can assist you here at PNW. We have a little bit of free information. We also could become a bit of your advisor around cash flow. Get ahead of it, not behind. Cash flow management means cutting expenses except for your marketing up to 30% wherever it's possible. You don't want to be hoping the COVID virus and the vaccine comes into play by fall, hoping for phase three to arrive if you're here in the county. We all want that to happen yesterday. Hope is not a reality. You want to be fully actionable and to survive. You want to cut some expenses, again, up to 30% except for your marketing. Next is make sure also that you begin to account, as previously mentioned, begin to look at your books much more often, work with your bookkeeper. If you are, make sure you're collecting the ledger and doing your expenses daily. Now is the time. The number one way to get your money is to manage it more closely, more accurately. back to mindset, double vision. So now close your eyes. Think about being on your yacht in 2022 because you're taking a lovely vacation, visiting Mykonos, Greece, and the Mediterranean. Life is good. You've survived, and now you're thriving. Please do spend some time. As an individual that loves to teach, coach, and run my businesses, I know that much of the success of myself, you, and my own team has to do with the psychology. Make sure you're managing today for your future. As I've said numerous times, but I'm trying to add to your mindset, to thrive, you must survive. Know your cash positions, do the cash management. Please make sure your accounting is current. If you hate it or you're not very good at it, this is something you must delegate to someone within your company or find your own accountant or tax person or come to someone like PNW, we can help you. One of the models that's happening now is that accounting, since money never sleeps and you want profits every month, is no longer a twice event year. Even if you hire your bookkeeping, make sure that you get involved with your accountant on a regular basis. Again, money never sleeps. And the cloud accounting that's now happening, you know how we used to buy Microsoft software for us old timers or mature people, you put it on a large Dell server in the 1990s and that was it. Now you pay for cloud subscription, SaaS it's called, software as a service. This is the future of tax and accounting. And here's the beautiful thing. You want transparency. You want visibility around what you're doing every month, not just during COVID, not just when the tide goes out and you know who's not wearing swim trunks. Begin more and more to understand that in good times and bad, business is both a balance sheet, that's keeping your cash and growing your assets, and a P&L, how much money you're making. One thing I'm bringing up here, I just dropped this on here into our screen too, is you can now take net operating losses by going back 5 years and getting a refund from the IRS. We don't have time to go into any further detail at this point, but please, again, make a note, the CARE Act, another place to get more cash, and I threw it onto this screen, is to get net operating losses that can go back 5 years. That way you can get checks in the mail from the federal government. Another angle of getting more money. And again, I call this little section double vision. Step number three is the strategic work. You're working hard now, you're trying to stay in business, you're trying to reopen and hire. Make sure you know the direction you're going. Under a worst case scenario, you may need to put your business on pause. I work closely with a business down south in the great state of Oregon, and they have put their bricks and mortar business on pause. I'm a coach to this individual. It's kind of a family member, and so I do that as a side. Their online business, however, is exploding. So strategically, they aren't doing as much with bricks and mortar, their actual pet shop. Instead, they're going online, less piercings and more of the jewelry. That's the way of the future coming quickly. You know why the stock market is booming? It's because suddenly we're all understanding that the online world that was already in effect since you bought your first eBay or your first Amazon package is now suddenly upon us. In my view, much of the change that's happened the last 100 days with COVID is basically 2 years of life dropping into our lap. What does that mean? It means no yacht. That's later. Today, it's lifeboat tactics. Here is one of the greatest things you can get from this chat today. It's not so much about tax and accounting. It's about why you're in business. Love your clients and communicate with them double or triple what you usually do. Why does this matter? When you look at numbers, if we were doing a review of the financial marketing numbers in your company as a way, as your trusted advisor, your profit advisor, to help you make more money next year, we would truly say, how much are you returning from your current clients? In other words, what's your gross revenue or total income? Most of you would say, well, I get like 70% of my money from primary clients. And I would ask you how much you invest into those clients. Sadly, we tend, even as businesses, to take for granted the great relationships in our life. I ask you not to do that anymore. In fact, I require you, email, call, offer new ways, find out what you can offer for free, and more importantly, see what you can sell your current clients. Why don't you finance them? If you're in the service business, it's not difficult to set up a finance system. As I mentioned before, an AR and collections could bring money back in, cash into your bank to go ahead and pull financing, offer to spend or let your clients pay you over a few months. Do the same thing with your best clients. Instead of charging them
Dianette and James, are you guys still there?
Hi, Crystal. I can't hear James anymore.
Okay, I think he froze. Well, hang tight, everyone. I apologize for that. We will get things back up and running.
Let's see here.
Hey, isn't the Zoom world fun? Amazing virtual activity.
Hi, we are back.
Thank you guys. Hey, that was a quick switch.
We're being resourceful.
We didn't lose anyone, so thank you guys. So go ahead, James.
Thank you so much. See, we're being resourceful. That's one of the other opportunities. It's also called Murphy, right? We're back to Thrive, and we're in the closing stretch. This is First and Goal. Thank you all for being on today. James Preston, PNW, and Dianette Galindez. Special thanks to the Chamber. Crystal, you're amazing. We all wish we were with you up there at the resort. So glad there's some reopening. Cash during a recession is key. Warren Buffett said, when the tide goes out, you can tell who's not wearing some trunks. As we've finished up and we're nearly done today, I've urged us to look at four steps we can take as small business owners to immediately get more conservative. So the way to thrive right now is to survive. And you do that by being more balance sheet focused, less P&L. You also begin to bring in the discipline that your company needs. Look accurately at cutting expenses except for marketing, going after the government programs, making sure you and your team are coming to us for help if you need at PNW here in Olympia, that you're getting your PPP and your EIDL money. Secondly, you're doing the tactical things in terms of your business, the hack of watching your expenses daily, also collecting your accounts receivable, and most important, going strategic, loving on your clients, marketing still, and being innovative. This is actually an opportunity. The greatest investors, the greatest business people, the true skilled leaders, and we all have it within us. We're members of the chamber. We're able to find those associates, actually build market share during challenging times. Please see that crisis equals opportunity. It truly does. And most of that's mindset, as we've talked. One of the last things then I'll touch briefly with you on is to make sure as you're looking here that you truly see a story called Acres of Diamonds. This is a book. It's a historical true book, maybe historical fiction, of a gentleman who searched the world for his fortune, and he came back to his hometown that he left when he was young. Please make sure you find your own Acres of Diamonds right here in Thurston County. And one of the last things I'll bring up, we don't need to take any more time today, is change the model. Mindset means there's new realities we need to have in tough times and good times.
there's more competition than ever, less market share, fewer people have money in some cases. Please make sure your accountant and tax advisor speaks plain English. And just like when you're going down the road to go on vacation or find a new client, you're looking ahead for danger and opportunities. Please make sure that your tax accountant and CPA is looking ahead as well. If all you do is a tax return twice a year, personal and business, you are missing one of the greatest opportunities in your business to make more money so you can save it and retire early. Please ask your accountant to begin looking ahead with you, advising yourself based on your goals, where you want to go, so you can make more money toward financial freedom, cash flow, and profits. In closing today, then, just remember you can request our ebook. That would be wonderful. Support at PNW.com. And we have a lot more tidbits and ideas. Again, I just want to give a special thank you for all of you being on today. Thank you, Crystal, Dianette. And I would ask you to all look at ways to save cash, get through the recession, and build stronger and be more profitable than ever. Tough times make tough people. And I appreciate this chance to share.
Thank you so much, James. And I like your guys' quick adjustment to technology. We got to love the world, as you said. You know, I thoroughly enjoyed your presentation. You know, I like the part you mentioned on business leaders to just stay positive right now. And it really has that ripple effect within our employees and our business. And just to keep that happy mindset that you were talking about, it couldn't be more true. So right now, I welcome any questions anybody has. I think I posted it early, but I realized I had posted it just to our panelists, but that doesn't help our listeners. So if anybody has any questions right now, please feel free to include them in the chat section or the Q&A section, and we will address those. Just want to thank PNW Community Tax Service again. I'll wait to see if any questions come up. You know, we've been doing business essentials with the chamber, you know, quickly into COVID-19. And now, you know, it was business essentials during COVID. And now we're kind of moving beyond COVID. But it's great to know that there's still some access to cash right there for our businesses that are, you know, maybe might be in the phase three, the phase four, and just needs additional help right now. So super appreciate all the insight on that. So with that, I'll go ahead and close it. I don't see any questions. So this webinar will be recorded. I encourage you guys to reach out to James at PNW if you guys have any further questions, and access the free ebook and resources that he's shared with us. So thank you both so much for being our panelists today. And I hope everybody enjoys their weekend. Stay safe and enjoy the sunshine.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Have a great weekend. Yes. Bye-bye.
Bye.